Hey guys, welcome back. Today I want to start working on the neck, and I'm going to start, I'm not going to attach it to the body yet. I'm going to work on installing the truss rod and tapering the neck, as well as cutting out the final profile, if you will, of the peg head. And I have some templates here that I've made from my plans. I basically made copies of the plans, cut them out, and glued them to some quarter inch plywood, and I'll use that to help me shape everything. So first thing I want to do is I want to establish my center line. So I went ahead and did that here. This is a rough center line of the rubber blank. That's where I'm thinking about possibly installing the nutserts for the bolt-on neck, although I haven't really finalized that position yet. In fact, I'm not going to do that until the neck is almost completely shaped with the fretboard on, while I then start laying that out. But I did want to get the center line, and I then, using a marking gauge, transfer that center line down the net blank. And my truss rod is from LMI. It's about 15 1/4 inches, and I'm going to install this as a reverse truss rod. And I have about 1 1/4 inches of a neck block in the body. So this overhang will be just fine, and it'll, what we'll do is we'll route out a corresponding channel in the top of the body of the guitar to accommodate this protruding truss rod. What I want to do now is just take this over to the table saw, and I'm going to use the table saw to essentially make a dado, so to speak. This is roughly 3/16 thick. Yep, 3/16, and we are going to make it roughly 3/8 inch deep. Alright, so let's go over to the table saw and start working on that. So I'm going to set the height of the blade by using the truss rod as a guide. Let's see what the thickness of this blade is. It's about 1/8 inch thick. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set my fence so I'm making a cut right down the center. So I've got the fence set so that the blade is it's roughly in the middle. Maybe I'll make a little adjustment there. And it is, let's double check. So I'll make one pass down the center, and I want to stop right before where the nut is, where the nut's going to lie. I'm going to transfer this line to the side. Do that on both sides. that is where I want my cut to stop. So when I'm running it through, paste this line so I don't get confused. I want the blade to stop right at that line. So I need to find out where that blade starts cutting. We get a piece of tape. So as I'm feeding it through the saw, that's where I'm going to stop. All right, so let's go ahead and make our first cut there. First pass now, because the blade is rounded, it doesn't quite go over to my line, so I'm going to just make a measurement there of how far off that is, and then I'll know exactly how far forward I need to push it to be able to reach that. Measure forward 11/16. And then I'll just use a chisel to square that off. So now we got to move the fence, really just a 16th, not even a 16th.
Thank you.
All right. Ready?
scratch it on the side. You suck up on this.
Sure. No, not that. Turn that off. No, that's for the router. The thing is on there. Chip out here, but that'll be easy to fix. And at this point, it's just time to start rough shaping everything with rasps and all that good stuff. I am probably going to cut a lot of this off with a handsaw. Contour this heel cap, you have to translate that down to this edge here. So bulk of that I'll just cut off with a pull saw, with a coping saws. They make quick work of it. And we'll get started on that. Alright, I set my marking gauge to 3/8 of an inch. And that's about the distance where the radius of the neck started,
roughly.
I'm just using that line as a reference. So that when I start shaping, I know where I need to stop.
Thank you.
I set my marking gauge to 3/8 of an inch, and that is about, that's about the distance where the radius of the neck starts, roughly. I'm just using that line as a reference. So the peg head thickness, plans call for about 9/16. So I set the marking gauge to 9/16. Just a So, I had some issues with the SD card. I lost some footage of some of the shaping that I've been doing here on the neck, but I'm bringing up the speed of where I'm at this point. I've got it, a lot of it shaped, a lot of the contour is where I want it. I'm close, but I'm not quite there. I took some measurements off of my plan. So basically rough measurements, something I guess to go by, because I guess everyone, you know, is going to like their neck a little bit different, but I still need to come down on the thickness to this line. I'm still a little thick here, and even in this area I could take quite a bit off still on the heel, this transition, if that's easy to see. This part here, this transition, I can come off. You can see the line here. I'm not going to go too crazy here, but I am going to take a bunch more off. one thing to note that you should be cognizant of is channel here for the truss rod. You could just take a gauge on how deep that is. You can see that. It's still well above this line here that I'm referencing. So you do want to check that every now and again, because you don't want to sand or remove too much material and come into that channel. So I'm going to spend a little time on the I'm going to take a bunch of material off using the oscillating spindle sander and see if that can make quick work of this, and then go back to shaping a bit. All right, let's do that.